Senate Judiciary Committee. On my right is Senator Boylan, who is our ranker. I would like to introduce you to the senators that are here. I'll start with Senator Kavanaugh there on the end, Senator Kaminsky, Senator Boyle, Senator Jacobs, Senator Stavisky, Senator Breslin, Senator Serino, Senator Phillips, Senator Sepulveda, practiced in that name all time, Senator Bailey, Senator DeLon, Senator O'Mara, Senator Lanza, Senator Amador, Senator Razenhofer, Senator Montgomery, and last but not least, Senator LaValle and Senator Hamilton. Okay. Oh, and Senator Young right there. Okay. Welcome to everyone. Welcome to the judges, potential judges. I have to tell you a little story before I start. Yesterday to my judiciary members, you remember, Brielle Christian, my counsel, was sitting here. This morning, she was in the hospital giving birth to a daughter, almost 9 pounds. So, you know, counsel's primary responsibilities when the judges come up. Missing in action today, but well worth, you know, what she's achieved. So that's a wonderful story. Now let me start in no order, but I'm going to go with Dave Lewis first. Dave, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Do you want to have a seat up there when you're ready? Mr. Lewis resides in Hastings on the Hudson, New York, and since 2011, he served as counsel to the majority leader in the New York State Senate. He's also a partner in private practice since 1980 and concentrates in criminal defense. Additionally, Mr. Lewis has given more than 100 continuing legal education presentations in over 45 states, focusing on evidence, expert witnesses, trial techniques, and storytelling in the courtroom. So would any senator like to speak on this nominee?
He looks familiar.
Senator LaValle.
I have a next question because we're going to lose great counsel in the Senate. And if you look through his resume, you will see how learned he is, or we assume from the resume he is learned. But I had the opportunity to know David through his father, who was a colleague of ours. I still miss him to this very day. So I've known David through his dad and had the pleasure of spending 10 days with he and his mom on a little adventure through Italy, London, and Paris. So, David, your resume speaks for itself, and I think those of us who know you and the work that you've done in the legislature will be a great judge because you have a wonderful temperament.
Thank you. Would any other senator like to speak on this nominee? Hearing? Senator Breslin.
David, we're delighted to see you go. It's my universal benefit. He's been an extraordinary public servant and very deserving of this designation to go on the bench. At this point in time, with the academic background you have and your tremendous government experience, I know you'll be a wonderful judge.
Thank you.
Anyone else wish to speak? Senator
Stavisky? Yeah, I too want to echo what's been said. I remember your dad very well. Not only did he serve in the state senate, but became superintendent of the courts. Thank you. Banking or insurance?
Insurance.
Insurance. So you have good genes, and I think you will be a really good judge, because I think you will weigh the evidence and make a fair decision. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Senator Stavisky. Senator Boyle.
I, too, would like to echo the sentiments. Dave, tremendous lawyer. He's taught and trained us all about ethics in this legislature. And to this day, he's probably the only person who's ever beat my wife in Trivial Pursuit.
Anyone else wishes to speak? Hearing none, I'd like to move the nomination of Mr. Lewis. All in favor?
Aye.
David, thank you very much, David.
Thank you, Senator. Okay.
The next nominee that I'd like to call up is Chris Kelly. Welcome, Judge Kelly.
Thank you, Senator.
Judge Kelly is currently a district court judge in Central Islip, New York, and she presides over the driving while intoxicated part. Previously, she served as an acting county court judge assigned to the domestic violence part, a district court judge presiding over criminal matters, and a county attorney referee in both Suffolk County Supreme Court and Family Court. She's been in private practice for 12 years with special emphasis on criminal law, matrimonial law, and family law matters. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Senator LaValle.
Ms. Kelly is a resident of the village of Port Jefferson. And as many of you know, I am also a resident of the village. If you look at the resume, it is incredible. Chris, you've really done a wonderful job. Spent some time in the First Senate District out in the East End, Southampton, out in the East End. So it's amazing what you have done in your lifetime. And good luck to you as you move through the rest of the
day. Would any Senator Kaminsky?
Hello, Your Honor. I like to use these opportunities as a way for us legislators to learn a little bit more about what goes on in court. We make decisions every day about the criminal justice system, sometimes a little bit too far removed. So this isn't really probing your qualifications. You're eminently qualified on the court voting for you. But with respect to domestic violence court, we deal with domestic violence issues here a lot. What tools would be helpful to judges to help administer justice in domestic violence courts and make sure that victims are protected and that the courts are running smoothly? Is there anything we could do to help judges in those situations so that defendants are being treated in the fair respect that they deserve, but at the same time, victims are protected and the public is being served?
I would love to speak on that. It's a difficult question for a judge to answer, honestly, because it, I think, by its very nature, will require me to speak about policy issues and offer suggestions for potential legislation, which is really not my role as a judge. I worked in that court and in the Integrated Domestic Violence Court in the Supreme Court as a court attorney referee and handled many of those cases as a prosecutor. They are inherently difficult, and judges who work in those courts are constantly tasked both now with acting as problem solvers with a goal to end violence, but at the same time, our first and foremost responsibility is to ensure the proceedings are fair to an accused. So I found it an extraordinarily worthwhile part to work in, but a terribly difficult part to work in. You have really have to maintain a zen-like, you know, distance from what is happening.
I was there with Judge Camacho.
And Judge Camacho is one of my role models.
Yeah, my goal was just to not get yelled at every day.
But we really walk a razor's edge, you know, as judges in some of those parts. And I'm sorry I couldn't more directly answer your question.
Any other questions? Anybody else like to have a question for Judge Kelly? Hearing none, I would like to move the nomination of Judge Kelly. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so moved. Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you, Senator.
What we're going to do now is the three interim appointments to the Supreme Court, okay? First one is Nicholas Iacovetta. I hope I didn't slur that. Iacovetta, okay. He resides in the Bronx. He has served on the Court of Claims since 1994, but has been a criminal court judge of the City of New York in the 12th Judicial District since 1988. Now, prior to that, he served 14 years in the Bronx County DA's office, where he was a bureau chief of the Criminal Court Bureau and was responsible for training 40 to 50 new prosecutors a year. Quite impressive. Does anyone have any questions of this nominee? Good, hearing none. On the nominee, Senator Kaminsky.
Hi, Your Honor. How is the Bronx doing with its case backlog?
I think significantly better than it was reported a couple of years ago.
So we're making progress?
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you.
Anyone else like to speak on this nominee? Hearing none, I'd like to move the nomination of Judge Iacovetta. Iacovetta to the chambers. Your Honor, thank you for appearing today. We'll see you in the chambers. Okay.
Thank you all for having me here. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Our next judge is Vincent Martorana. There's a lot of Italian guys here. What is it, Kenny? Martorana, that's easy. Judge Martorana resides in Holbrook, New York. He has served as a district court judge in Suffolk since 2012. Prior to becoming a judge, he's had his own private practice for 27 years, focused on personal injury, insurance law, contracts, and medical malpractice. He spent 4 years as a uniformed court officer in the civil court of the City of New York. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Senator Boyle.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd just like to say that I've known Judge Martorana for many years. He was an exceptional trial attorney. He's even a better jurist, and I know he's going to do wonderful things. And as anybody goes through the system, you know, you get chances to run for judge. Judge Martorana stepped aside numerous times in his career. He was long overdue to come to the bench, and he's even better now going forward. I'm so happy to
have you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Senator Boyle. Anyone else? Hearing none, I'd like to move.
Senator Lavelle.
Oh, Senator Lavelle.
I wanted to echo what Senator Boyle said and to certainly move the nomination. Or maybe Senator Boyle move it and I'll second it.
Perfect.
Perfect. All those in favor?
Aye.
Judge Martorana, thank you very much. We'll see you in a little while. Judge Michael Opus. Judge Opus resides in New York, New York, and has served as an acting justice of the Supreme Court of the State of New York since 1993. He was a judge of the Criminal Court of the City of New York for 6 years prior to his Court of Claims appointment. Additionally, he's worked as a legal aid society of Nassau County for 13 years. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Okay, hearing none, I'd like to move the nomination of Judge Otis. All in favor? Okay, Judge.
Thank you, Honor.
Now we'll continue with the new appointments for the Court of Claims. Mr. Joel Cohen. Mr. Cohen resides in White Plains, New York. He's been at Davis, Polk, and Wardwell LLP since 1987 and a partner since 1996. While at that law firm, he is focused on commercial litigation, government investigations, and transactional work. He received the Thurgood Good Marshall Award for successfully representing a pro bono client at a habeas corpus proceeding that resulted in vacating his death sentence and conviction. Quite impressive. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Okay, hearing none, I'd like to move the nomination of Mr. Cohen. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, no one opposed? Mr. Cohen, congratulations. Next one is John Higgin. Mr. Higgin resides in White Plains, New York. Since 2011, he's been a referee and principal court attorney to the administrative judge of the 12th Judicial District. Additionally, he has served within the New York State Supreme Court since he graduated law school in various capacities, including chief court attorney in the appellate term of the First Judicial Department and confidential law clerk for two justices. He was an adjunct professor of law at Benjamin Cardoza School of Law from 2007 to 2010. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Okay, hearing none, I'd like to move the nomination of Mr. Higgin. All in favor?
Aye.
Anybody opposed? Okay, Mr. Higgin, we'll see you next time. The next person is Francis Kahn III, who resides in Senator Kaminsky's district. Mr. Kahn resides in Lynbrook, New York. Since 1998, he's worked with the New York State Supreme Court system. For the past 7 years, he's been the principal law clerk to the Honorable Peter Kelly in Queens County Surrogates Court. Previously, he served as the principal law clerk to two separate judges in the civil term of the Supreme Court in Jamaica, New York. He is also on the board of directors of the Catholic Lawyers Guild of Queens County. Anybody, any senator like to speak on the nominee? You know I'm not. I'd like to move the,
if you're really from Queens, let me say that I've known Mr. Kahn's mother for many years when she was a member of the school board and a very active member of our community, and I know the work that the Surrogates Court has done and the other courts where you served, and I congratulate you and your mother, probably a very happy mother, on your nomination.
Thank you. Okay, any other senator like to speak on this nominee? Hearing none, I'd like to move the nomination of Mr. Kahn to the chambers. All in favor?
Aye.
Anybody opposed? Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
We have three left. James McCarthy Jr. Mr. McCarthy resides in Marinette, New York. He's been employed by the Westchester County DA's office since 1980 and currently serves as first deputy district attorney chief assistant. Additionally, he served as the acting district attorney from January 2016 to December 2016. And oversaw a staff of over 230 employees. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee?
Mr.
Anybody?
Yes.
Senator Bill.
So, regarding your resume and your qualifications are, beyond approach, but I guess I would just look at you've been in the DA's office since 1980. And I just want to just make a comment as to my position on criminal justice reform, that I would just like to be mindful of that while you obviously, again, have all the qualifications, and the government has done an excellent job in putting you here. I would just like to make sure I state on the record that, criminal justice reform is something that's very real and important to our community, as much as the county that I represent, the city of Mount Vernon. So, in supporting your confirmation, I just want to make sure I put that on the record and just put that in your mind, everybody else's minds.
I understand. Thank you.
Anyone else wishes to speak? Hearing none, I'd like to move the nomination of Mr. McCarthy to the floor. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. I'm going to jump out of order here. I've been told that... I've been told that we may not have voted for Judge Icavetta. I now would like to move the nomination of Judge Icavetta to the floor. All those in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Okay. That's going to the floor. All right. Michelle Rodney. Miss Rodney resides in New York City. She has served as the dean of the School of Criminal Justice at Monroe County, Bronx, New Rochelle, and St. Lucia campuses. She previously worked as an assistant DA in Bronx County in the Homicide Unit and is an adjunct professor of criminal justice at Monroe College. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee?
Sure.
Who? Are you hiding me over there?
No, listen, I'm
okay. Senator Bailey.
You can also hear, so, well, I'm very sad that I won't be before you, Dean Rodney, anymore, as in your role at Monroe College, but your experience speaks for itself. Since the DA's office, you've been involved in higher ed, which I think gives you a nice understanding of what, you know, judicial temperament that takes in. Having interacted with you at Monroe College on many occasions, specifically related to police community relations, you understand both sides of the point very well. And I'm very excited to support you going forward. I also have to say, Mr. Chair, that she might live in the city now, but she's from my district. She's from my district, and one of the parents, Mr. Carl Rodney and Mary Rodney, are also here. They're also a great community resident, so I just want to say, I'm very excited to see you on the bench, but I don't know what my role is going to do. Right? So I support the nomination, Mr. Chair.
Anyone else like to speak on the nominee? Senator Sepulveda. He seems to...
Okay. Yeah, practice. Mr. Chairman, I just want to say, a very good friend of mine, someone who I have the utmost respect for, a childhood friend, law school buddy, worked in the Bronx District Attorney's Office. I don't know if it's fair that I say his name here, but Robert Holdman told me that the judge could not have done a better job in making this election. And so he sends his regards and best wishes, and I, too, would like to say I wish you all the best.
Thank you, Senator Lanza. Senator Sepulveda.
I also want to commend this choice. I saw your name, I looked into your resume, I spoke to Senator Bailey, and I thought it was one of the things to say about you. I appreciate your record, your experience in academia, your legal experience, I think, gives you a certain flavor as a judge and temperament that will make you a fantastic judge. But I want to say a statement not about you, but in general. It's good to see individuals that come from neighborhoods that are represented communities of color, especially women, ascending to the bench. I am extremely disappointed that the number of Latinos that have been nominated by the governor is minimal, and I think we have to do a better job of that. I'm going to continue to push that as part of my member of the Latino Caucus in the Senate. And we need to get more Latinos involved so that we can make them judges. They are wonderful lawyers that are qualified just like you. So I want to commend you, congratulate, and I hope that you serve as a role model for our communities for years to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Anyone else like to speak? Hearing none, I'd like to move the nomination of Ms. Rodney to the floor. Congratulations and thank you very much. We should vote for her.
Yes.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so carried. We'll have a few minutes to take pictures when we're done. Anyone that would like to with their prospective judges. Next up is Lillian Wan from Senator Kavanaugh's district. She resides in Brooklyn. Since 2013, she has served as the family court judge in Kings County Family Court. She previously worked as an interim civil court judge in Bronx County Family Court, as county attorney referee in Kings County Surrogates Court, and she litigated child abuse cases with the administration for children's services in New York City. Would any senator like to speak on this topic? Senator Hamilton.
Yes, thank you, Jim. I just want to say I'm limiting you on some time now between individuals, which is a great person, a great parent, so you have a husband, a son, and daughter. This is a great accomplishment for you. And I've known on the personal side, also the legal side. I work in a survey of court where people are dealing with issues of state matters at difficult times. And she's also on the family court. And I say people just on family court have compassion. Family court in Brooklyn, Kings County is the largest county to put out there, largest county state. 2.6 million people. And if you can imagine the case when it comes to Kings County family court, and this is people around here, and sometimes people need help. They have baby cases, abuse cases, neglect cases. And a family court judge can't leave the family. A lot of times they act on this. And people stay there because they're compassionate people and wanting to serve. Lillian wants a person who wants to serve well on the court of family. And I'm happy that she's here. I recommend that highly, I'm wishing you a great job. And I'm here to say I support her.
Thank you, Senator.
Any other? Senator Kavanaugh.
I have not had the opportunity to work personally with Judge Vaughn, but know my reputation is very well regarded in the current role. I've also only been a senator in Brooklyn for the past 6 months. We had a Manhattan resident of the 26th Senate District appointed yesterday. It's nice that we'll have, you know, each side of the river properly represented on the court. And also just, you know, to echo something that Senator Sepulveda said, it is very important that we have courts that are diverse and represent the many perspectives and backgrounds in our state. And you know, we appreciate that Judge Juan will bring her unique perspective as an Asian American woman to the court.
Thank you, Senator.
Just want to make a comment. I just want to acknowledge that she was a spelling bee judge at the Summer Literacy Program Festival in Washington, D.C.
Senator Stavisky.
Yes, I too want to echo really what Senator Sepulveda said about the diversity and the governor's nominations, because I'm, my colleagues know I represent an Asian district, and we have very few Asian judges, and I think that is something that hopefully will change, and certainly I congratulate you. I believe you're going to be the first Asian American member of the Court of Claims.
Female.
But let's hope that this becomes a pattern for additional qualified Asian American representatives for the same reasons that have been mentioned before. So I congratulate you.
Thank you, Senator Stavisky. Anyone else like to speak on this nominee? Hearing none, I know Senator Kavanaugh moves the nomination, seconded by Senator Hamilton. All those in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed? All right, congratulations. Governor Cuomo has sent us these 11 impressive candidates because of their temperament and dedication to the bench. Both the three interim Supreme Court candidates, as well as the 8 new nominations to the Court of Claims. They've been moved to the Senate floor. They'll be taken up and voted on for final confirmation by the full body. It is now 20-6, and the meeting of the Judiciary Committee is adjourned, and I thank everyone for being here. Okay.